transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonic Wave, transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonic Wave, transforming text into the audio realm. Our programs are produced entirely in the USA and read by professional narrators who are compensated for their services at prevailing union rates. We hope you enjoy this program.
The Invisible Giant by Bram Stoker, 1881. Time goes on in the country under the sunset, much as it does here. Many years passed away, and they wrought much change. And now we find a time when the people that lived in good King Mago's time would hardly have known their beautiful land if they had seen it again. It had sadly changed indeed. No longer was there the same love or the same reverence toward the king. No longer was there perfect peace. People had become more selfish and more greedy, and had tried to grasp all they could for themselves. There were some very rich, and there were many poor. Most of the beautiful gardens were laid waste. Houses had grown up close round the palace, and in some of these dwelt many persons who could only afford to pay for part of a house. All the beautiful country was sadly changed, and changed was the life of the dwellers in it. The people had almost forgotten Prince Zaphir, who was dead many, many years ago, and no more roses were spread on the pathways. Those who lived in the country under the sunset laughed at the idea of more giants, and they did not fear them because they did not see them. Some of them said, "Tush, what can there be to fear? Even if there ever were giants, there are none now." And so the people sang and danced and feasted as before, and thought only of themselves. The spirits that guarded the land were very, very sad. Their great, white, shadowy wings drooped as they stood at their posts at the portals of the land. They hid their faces, and their eyes were dim with continuous weeping, so that they heeded not if any evil thing went by them. They tried to make the people think of their evil doing, but they could not leave their posts. And the people heard their moaning in the night season and said, "Listen to the sighing of the breeze. How sweet it is!" So is it ever with us also, that when we hear the wind sighing and moaning and sobbing round our houses in the lonely nights, we do not think our angels may be sorrowing for our misdeeds, but only that there is a storm coming. The angels wept evermore, and they felt the sorrow of dumbness, for though they could speak, those that they spoke to would not hear. Whilst the people laughed at the idea of giants, there was one old man who shook his head and made answer to them when he heard them, and said, "Death has many children, and there are giants in the marshes still. You may not see them, perhaps, but they are there, and the only bulwark of safety is in a land of patient, faithful hearts." The name of this good old man was Knoal, and he lived in a house built of great blocks of stone in the middle of a wild place, far from the city. In the city there were many great old houses, story upon story high, and in these houses lived many poor people. The higher you went up the great steep stairs, the poorer the people were that lived there, so that in the garrets were some so poor that when the morning came they did not know whether they should have anything to eat the whole long day. This was very, very sad, and gentle children would have wept if they had seen their pain. In one of these garrets there lived all alone a little maiden named Zaya. She was an orphan, for her father had died many years before, and her poor mother, who had toiled long and wearily for her dear little daughter, her only child, had died also not long since. Poor little Zaya had wept so bitterly when she saw her dear mother lying dead, and she had been so sad and sorry for a long time that she quite forgot that she had no means of living. However, the poor people who lived in the house had given her part of their own food, so that she did not starve. Then, after a while, she had tried to work for herself and earn her own living. Her mother had taught her to make flowers out of paper, so that she made a lot of flowers, and when she had a full basket, she took them into the street and sold them. She made flowers of many kinds, roses and lilies, and violets and snowdrops, and primroses and mignonette, and many beautiful sweet flowers that only grew in the country under the sunset. Some of them she could make without any pattern, but others she could not. So when she wanted a pattern, she took her basket of paper and scissors and paste and brushes and all the things she used, and went into the garden which a kind lady owned, where there grew many beautiful flowers. There she sat down and worked away, looking at the flowers she wanted. Sometimes she was very sad, and her tears fell thick and fast as she thought of her dear dead mother. Often she seemed to feel that her mother was looking down at her, and to see her tender smile in the sunshine on the water. Then her heart was glad, and she sang so sweetly that the birds came around her and stopped their own singing to listen.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.